factor. So what is force? When we apply force on any object, that means either we push a body or we pull a body, we observe certain displacement. That means body is displaced from one place to another, or the shape of the body or the size of the body can be changed, and the speed of the object can be either increased or decreased. Then we have studied for the direction. When we apply force, the direction can be changed. Then we have studied when a body is at rest, it can be moved, or a moving body can be brought at rest. Then we have studied for the types of force. So let us see the types of force we have studied, that is contact force and non-contact force. So contact force is divided in three parts, that is muscular force, mechanical force, frictional force. And non-contact force is also distributed in three types, that is electrostatic force, magnetic force and gravitational force. So these differentiation or the types we have studied. Now let us come to further force of friction. Now this frictional force we are going to study in deep. So what is friction? Friction is a contact force that comes into action whenever a body moves or tries to move over a surface. It also acts opposite to the direction of force. So how we can understand better the force of friction? Supposing if we are rubbing our hands. So while rubbing our hand, we are moving our hands in opposite direction. That means one hand is going upward and the other hand is going downward. So we see that the body moves in opposite direction. So that is only the force of friction. Next, in activity number 5, it's given to show the force of friction. So here a bicycle is taken. So while pedaling bicycle, what we observe? We are pedaling the bicycle and the cycle moves forward. So what do we observe? While moving forward, the road we leave behind back. So this is what the bicycle, and on pedaling, the cycle is moving forward, and while applying brakes, what we observe? On applying brakes, the cycle gets stopped. And if we do not apply brake, then also the cycle can be brought to rest. How we can say? If we in starting pedal, after that we do not pedal, then what happens? The speed gets slower, and slowly and gradually the cycle comes to at rest. So why this is happening? Because frictional forces applied on the tire and the road. So what we can conclude is friction, or the force of friction, is natural force which opposes motion of one object on the surface of another object. Now let's go through the properties of friction. So the main first property is frictional force is produced only when object actually moves or tends to move over a surface of another object. That means there should be a contact force between the object and the surface. Then next one is frictional force opposes motion of one object over the surface of another. Thus it acts in direction opposite to that of motion. That means there should be an opposite motion. Then the amount of frictional force depends on the roughness or smoothness. So what we can say, if the surface is rough, like we can take the example of road. So road is quite rough. So when we are moving on the road, large frictional forces there. And supposing if we walk on glass or on tiles, so that surface is very smooth, so the frictional force is very less. Next property is the amount of friction depends on the mass of object moving over a surface. So higher the mass of the object, greater is the magnitude of the frictional force. What we can take, supposing this box is smaller and this box is heavier and bigger also. So when we are applying force on this object or box, more friction will be applied. And if a small box is there with less weight or less mass, less friction will be there. So this is how the friction is depending on the mass of object. Next is the amount of friction varies from surface to surface. Like example, if ball is allowed to roll on the wooden surface, its motion is stopped within a very short distance. And if the same ball is rolled on a hard cemented floor for much longer distance on a glass surface. So what we will see, when a ball is rolled on the glass surface, it will cover large distance. And if we roll the ball on the cemented surface or the rough surface, it will cover a shorter distance due to friction.